Hello and welcome to this special Christmas edition of Under the Covers with the Beatles. I'll be looking at Christmas Time Is Here again. See if anybody out there has bothered to cover that. They have. And also I'll be looking at the solo Christmas songs that the Beatles did. And let's be honest, they're more famous. Anyway, let's get on with it. Oh, thumbnail! Hello and welcome to Under the Covers with the Beatles. Thank you for joining me. Before I start, I have had quite a few new subscribers recently, quite a few. So just a quick reminder of what I tend to do in this series. I don't want you to disappear when I tell you this. I'm going through every single Beatles album track by track and I'm trying to find the best cover version of it. With your help, we can find better ones because I'm only one man and I'm the only person doing this right now. It's not the only thing I do on this channel. I do every now and then have a little moan. You know me, I like to have a little moan. Most of the time. So as I said earlier, this is the Christmas special. I don't know if you can see that. That there is basically a see-through Christmas tree. So, you know, the preparation for it has not been great. And there's a reason for that. In my last episode, I did say to you guys that, oh, I think I'm coming down with something. I'm not very well. Well, that took fruition. I've been off work. I've been really sick. It's just man flu, but any other men out there will know what I'm talking about. See, I have to keep clearing my throat. I'm not over it. I'm still sick. Going back to work tomorrow, though. Spread it around a bit. Spread the Christmas joy. So whilst I've been in my sick bed, I have been listening to Hold Me Tight by the Beatles, which was going to be my next episode. And then today I was like, right. Here we go, let's film that. And I went, oh, hang on a minute, it's Christmas. I'll do a Christmas episode instead. And so this is the most rushed episode I have ever done. You're welcome for the quality. Usually when I pick a track, I listen to nearly everything that there is. I've not done that on this occasion because time has been against me. And I'm still not great. Can you hear it in my voice? My balls dropped years ago. Now listen to it. Oh my God, Mum! Before I continue, just a quick note. If anything is muted, that's because I get copyright claims and some every now and then I have to mute a certain part of the video. So sorry about that. I do put all the links in the description, so go and check them out if you're actually interested in hearing them. I hope you are. Also, if you like what I'm doing here, please do just take a few seconds to like and subscribe. It really makes me feel warm inside. Thanks. Today's special Christmas episode is sponsored by the good folks at Air Duster. Have you ever like seen dust on something, but you can't be bothered to get a duster and, you know, just get it rid of it? Well, with this, you don't. Oh shit. I've lost that. Ever wanted to lose things? So thanks Air Duster. Thanks for sponsoring. So my idea, seeing as I had so little time, was just to, as I say, not do my mega research, but just to go, okay, who do I know who's famous on that list? Let's listen to that. Okay, it's good. I'll share it. But when it came to the John Lennon Happy Christmas, War Is Over, I learnt something. So, I'm going to show you, aren't I? But first, let's start with Christmas Time Is Here Again, recorded in 1967 for the Beatles fan club. But I didn't hear it until Free As A Bird. It's track 4 on the Free As A Bird single. This was a really good single at the time because obviously you got Free As A Bird, but also you got I Saw Her Standing There and This Boy. Two different outtakes that weren't on the anthology album, if I remember correctly. Am I remembering correctly? So for the sake of time, I'm just going to play them to you. I'm not going to announce each one, but obviously you'll see who it is. You'll be surprised by the first one. I was. Here they are.
Hello, everyone.
Now on to the Paul McCartney Christmas classic, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reggae. Of course not. As if to prove that I have done no research for this, just doing it now, and I. One second. Okay, so Wonderful Christmas Time was released in November 1979, 10 days later it was released in the US as well. It didn't chart in America, so screw you guys. It did very well in Great Britain, so, you know, well done us. It's one of my favourite Christmas songs, not just because Paul McCartney sang it, but I just like it, so sue me. I always like the boom, 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 bang, bang, bang. And that's exactly how it sounds. So, God, I'm good. Anyway, here's three cover versions that are okay. Actually, I will mention one of the cover versions. It's the first one you'll hear. It's Beatallica. And I've always been wondering, should I include Beatallica when it comes to the songs that they have covered? Should I include them? If you don't know who Beatallica are, they're a mix between the Beatles and Metallica. And their initial output was, they even changed the words, but it was always the tunes, heavily influenced by Metallica though, cover versions of Beatles songs. And then when they got really famous, the Beatles went, hey, no, you cover it properly with our words. Because, you know, the Beatles are really cool. So anyway, here's Beatallica, followed by two others, doing the words properly, because they have to, because the Beatles gave them a slap on the wrist. Sure about including that Gary Barlow one there, mainly because my missus said, oh, don't include that, it's shit. But I did it because she does not control me. After much deliberation, I have come to the conclusion that Happy Christmas, War Is Over is my favourite Christmas song in popular music. My actual favourite Christmas song is Silent Night. I know it's weird, right? But it's beautiful and it makes me think of Christmas. People that, you know, are trying to be cool say that Fairy Tale of New York is their favourite Christmas song. You know, it's a bit edgy. Oh, it says stuff that's not PC. Oh, I'm edgy. You guys can go fuck yourselves. Merry Christmas. So when I was trying to find cover versions of Happy Christmas, brackets, War Is Over, I always use a website called secondhandsongs.com. I always put it in the description. It's not the only place I look, but it's the main one. I'm very lazy. When I was looking there, it had loads and loads of people as the writers of this song. And I was like, huh, what are you on about? John Lennon was there, of course, and for some reason, Yoko Ono. But they're the two that you'd expect. But no, there was a list of names. And I was like, oh, what's going on there? Back in the 1940s, an artist called Woody Guthrie, he wrote a song called Scooble. It's all about a racehorse that was an underdog. Of course, underdog. I've listened to this and I really can't hear anything, but I guess it's all part of the song's journey. So here's that.
Way out in California.
1954, a guy called Johnny Ace released a song called Pledging My Love. And this sounds more like Happy Christmas, War Is Over. Did Lennon hear this? How is this? I don't know how this is actually connected to Skewball, because the lyrics are different. Like I said, I've done very little research, but this was all in the same section on secondhand songs. So here's that. This version I'm showing you, by the way, is from 1958, where they added some backing singers. It's my preferred version, so that's why I'm showing it to you.
Forever, my darling.
So you can definitely hear there's that melody. So the melody's been set now. Then in 1966, and this is possibly definitely the one that Lennon would have heard, it's the Hollies and their cover version of Skewball. Here's that.
Oh, Skewball was a racehorse, and I wished he were man. He never drank water, he always drank wine.
So anyway, yeah, that's what I learned today, is that it's almost not an original composition. Almost. I'm still going to give, you know, Lennon the kudos. I'm so cool. There were loads of cover versions of this particular track, more than the Paul McCartney track. I don't know what that says. I think we know what it says. So I have four recommendations for you from some very famous people. Probably why it's going to get muted. Enjoy.
And so this is Christmas, and what have we done? Another year older, and a new one just begun.
So this is Christmas, I hope you have fun. The near and the dear ones, the old and the young.
Well, a very Merry Christmas, ooh, and a Happy New Year. Yeah, let's go.
And lastly now, George Harrison. Oh, hang on a minute. Lastly, I think you'll find there's a fourth member of the Beatles, Paul. I think you've overlooked Ringo Starr. I have not overlooked him. So, lastly now, George Harrison. I don't think it's strictly a Christmas song, but it's a New Year's song. It's a New Year's song. And you know how everybody at the end of the year, they all get together and they do the Auld Lang Syne? I bloody hate Auld Lang Syne. And I really wish that this was adopted instead. It's called Ding Dong Ding Dong by George Harrison. And there's not many covers of it. No one likes it. It's just me and these two guys. So here's Ding Dong Ding Dong.
Bring out the old ring in the new. Bring out
that's it. Thank you very much. You have reached the end of the video. Not many people do make it this far, so if you are here, you are one of few. So let's just get comfortable, just have a chat. Oh, I knocked the camera. There you go. I knocked the camera at the end of the video. That's just what I do. Oh, so what you been up to, much? Yeah. I put a Christmas song out that I wrote years ago, but I put it out on YouTube and no one's watching it. I even tried to entice people that there is, I've ripped off the Beatles a little bit in that song. Tried to entice people to go there and try and figure out what Beatles song it was, and no one has decided to do that. But you know, you've made it to the end of this video, so maybe that'll be you. But who knows? Anyway, I'm not going to be doing another episode of Under the Covers this year. I will pick it up again in the new year. I want Christmas off, if that's all right. No one's going to be watching this during Christmas anyway. No one watches it now. So, I like this. I like this little alone time that we have. Anyway. Have a great Christmas, and I'll see you next year.